We're at the Omnia Clinic today with Natalie Kelly, and we have got another Halloween special for you. We are doing a vampire facial. Nelly is all numbed up, and Natalie is going to show you what she's about to do. Here we go.
Hi guys, so we've already taken the blood from Nelly. We've spun it in a centrifuge, which actually separates the red blood cells from the PRP. So this is the plasma. This has got all of the growth factors, and that's what we're going to use to re-stimulate some of Nelly's aging skin. So I'm going to prepare this now.
So if you've got any questions for us, please ping them over to us, because while we're with Natalie, she can answer any of your queries.
Scary.
Well, no,
it's not scary. All of that's gone, and we just use your nice little serum. So we'll give your face just a nice clean before we start.
Nelly, are you nervous?
Slightly. It's funny seeing your blood in two bits, because I've never ever seen that before. I've obviously had loads of blood tests, but I've never seen it, you know, separated.
Can you explain what happened with the blood at the first bit? Because no one saw that bit. We actually.
So we took a normal blood sample from Nelly.
And it's completely pain-free. She was brilliant.
She's very kind. We use the smallest needles when we're doing this for cosmetics for comfort. Then what we do is we put it in a special machine, which is called a centrifuge. And this separates the red blood cells from the PRP, which is the plasma, which has got all of the growth factors in it, all of the anti-aging ingredients that we're going to now use and re-inject back into Nelly's skin.
So we've all got this in our skin. It sounds crazy, but you just expect your blood to be red. Well, I do. Mm-hmm. And everyone expects this treatment to be very bloody. It may be, but keep watching.
But not as much as quite infamously, you know, the Kim Kardashian thing where she had this crazy face of blood and everybody believes that it's always going to be like that. It's not.
Okay. This is actually the Kim Kardashian.
It's usually more to the due to the vibration than it is the actual needles. Yeah. How you doing?
Yeah, fine. It's
slightly
painful, but not too bad. It's more of a sort of shock.
A little bit worse, just due to a thin skin there. That's all. It's more comfortable when we move down to the cheeks. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You're doing great.
It's going to be worth it, Nelly. You're going to look amazing after. So, what kind of skins is this good for?
Suitable for any skin types. Quite nice for the yummy mummy organic clients who don't want to use, you know, any fillers.
Yeah.
And they just want to use their own body's blood to repair and stimulate the skin.
Yeah.
It's also suitable for anyone with aging, sun-damaged skin like Nelly. Fantastic.
What sort of age would you recommend you start using this kind of thing?
I think anything from, you know, mid to late 20s, it all really depends on how well you've been looking after your skin and how you're aging, because in the past we've all been using sunbeds and whatnot and misbehaving.
Yeah, so. I was terrible. In the 80s, I was constantly on them. Terrible.
I used to work in a sunbed shop, if anyone wants to know. So I came to as well.
Oh, no.
I know.
Well done.
That's a lot less painful here.
Yeah, it's because you've got a little bit of fat on your cheek, which makes it much better.
Fat cheeks.
Yeah, no. You can hardly feel it now, so that's completely different.
I wonder if it's similar to semi-permanent makeup, the little needles.
This is not as bad, because I've tried both.
Okay. So have I. Oh, no, I haven't. I'm lying. Yeah. Sorry, I haven't tried this one.
Better mind your eyes. Well done. How are you feeling?
Yeah, but the forehead's quite painful because I think like this, no, but the actual size doesn't hardly feel at all. It's a very strange sensation. I mean, I've had quite a lot of things done over the years, and it's a very strange sensation. Can't really explain it.
But all good, you're not in any pain, are you?
No.
So if you're just tuning in and you're on your lunch, we are doing the vampire facial, the famous one that Kim Kardashian put all over her Instagram. Who else is having this? Quite a lot of them.
Loads of
celebs do these because it's a really good anti-aging treatment. As you can see, there's not a lot of blood, so we think she did that for a bit of attention. But this is the exact treatment that she would have done. And this is Natalie Kelly, who is a superstar for doing this. So if you've got any questions, ping them over.
You feeling okay?
Mm-hmm.
Alex wants to know, what exactly is a vampire facial?
So
Do you want to start again?
So a vampire facial is what we do to rejuvenate the skin. And we take a very small blood sample. We spin it in a centrifuge machine that separates the red blood cells, which you can see here, from the patient's PRP, which is the platelet-rich plasma. And then this is what we use to re-inject into the face for stimulation. So we'll be moving on to your chin.
Oh, my face feels like it's all tingling.
Yeah, like, if, you know, it definitely feels like a workout.
Yeah, it feels like there's something definitely done.
And if you ever want this done, actually, do you do it on yourself?
I can do it to myself, but to be honest, I get my skin therapist to give me a hand because it can still be a little bit tricky to...
Yeah, that is a silly question, but I thought
I'd ask. How are you feeling?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's something a little bit cannibalistic when you... doing the needles on yourself, isn't there?
Yeah. It's like a hairdresser doing their own highlights. Okay. So it's very interesting to watch this, and Nelly's not flinching. Of all the Instagram pictures we see of the celebs, they make it look so scary. She did flinch.
Tart lip does flinch a little bit.
More but still, it's not bad.
But otherwise, she's doing great, to be honest.
So this is good for sun damage?
Sun damage, acne, scarring, pigmentation, overall just skin rejuvenation. It's just a really natural treatment.
Now someone's asking how much they start from.
Okay, so it all depends on which clinic you're at and who's doing it, to be honest. But anything from 350 up to like 600, 800 is a reality.
Do you think it has better long-term benefits than something like fillers or Botox? Or?
I think fillers you have to use for if you want volume. This doesn't give any volume, this just works on the skin. Of course, it's working deep within the layers, stimulating, you know, the collagen, the growth factors that helping to reduce the melanocytes, which is what is stimulated by the sun for pigmentation. So in all honesty, suitable sort of for most.
Yeah. Oh, here comes the mask. So this is Nelly's Halloween mask. So you can see how quickly that happened.
No, it's not.
This has been in the fridge. It's pure hyaluronic acid. So we look a little bit ghostly. I'll try and get it to fit you.
Okay.
But it's really soothing and really hydrating because currently our skin... although you only seen some tiny pinpoints of bleeding, it has still created a trauma, and the trauma is what we want because then that heals and creates a wound healing response, which stimulates the collagen for the anti-aging that we want.
How long do you think till Nelly will see a difference in her skin?
What she'll probably see is the skin will feel quite tight, a little bit red, might feel a little bit like sunburn for a day or two. We just want her to wear some SPF if she's out and about. She'll feel like she definitely had something on. Some people quite like the tightness.
Yeah.
After a couple of days, she might notice that there's a slight little bit of dryness on the skin because this dermapen sort of provides a little bit of resurfacing, which can give the skin a really good glow. So I'd say up to about a week before an event, if you wanted a glow, some stimulation, and for the lines to feel a little bit plump, it's great. But then after a period of 4 to 6 months, that's when it works on the deeper collagen. So usually a course of three.
So three would do it.
Yeah.
So I know some people might think they're really expensive, but this is a really good anti-aging treatment. We can obviously come and check on Nelly in a few weeks, and you can be the judge if she looks any more youthful. So what's the mask is just soothing and healing.
The mask is soothing, so it has some zinc in, some copper peptides, some hyaluronic acid, so really it's just giving the skin a big drink, just really hydrating it and soothing it. So we've had this in the fridge, so it feels lovely once you feel like it's like maybe doing a workout in the gym and then putting on a nice cold, you know, cold towel, and you feel that refreshing. Yeah.
So would you not use all of the PRP?
Yeah, you can use a little bit more. I think sometimes I might go onto the neck, onto the chest, sometimes onto the hair. Sometimes you can give the client to take home and still keep applying, because up to about 3 hours, the little channels are still open and it can still be effective.
So Nelly can put some on tonight, if she so wishes.
Yeah, down to you.
Right, so Nelly has been having a vampire facial, so I don't know if anyone's clocking in now, but we're sort of at the end of it. She's just healing, but we thought we'd give you a little Halloween video, our second one this week.
She's very ghost-like.
Yeah, she's very ghost-like.
She looks like a mummy.
But they call this the vampire facelift, don't they?
Yeah.
And
the vampire term was just coined from because it's blood, you know, so people just see it as blood on the face. But although we do extract the blood and the plasma comes from the blood, we don't actually use the red blood cells. So you shouldn't usually see that much blood from the treatment.
Yeah.
Although if the red blood cells stay in here, once we've spun it in the centrifuge, and then we just use the PRP, which is the platelet-rich plasma that's full of all of that,
which is the goodness and
the growth factors. If you just started, God forbid, people at home to try this at home, taking your own blood and, you know, putting it on your face.
Yeah, do not be doing this at home. You need to come and see, I was going to say, your practitioner. Yes, I said it right. Like Natalie Kelly, who is based in Knightsbridge at the Omnia
Medical.
That's the one. Yes.
Okay, so should we reveal Nellie's skin and have a little look at what's going on there? So as you can see, a little bit of redness, mainly on the areas where there's thinner skin. But not really much blood, as you know, is shown if you Google PRP on the internet. So I think it gives quite a bit of a bad reputation.
Yeah, I think it probably scares people to sort of have it done. But you know, I thought we'd scare a few people today, but obviously not.
Is there anything you should avoid, sort of putting on your skin afterwards?
Definitely anything that's active. So if you're an anti-aging junkie and you're using retinols or exfoliators or chemical peels, wouldn't want you to be doing anything of that until your skin feels like it's resurfaced and it's feeling a little bit better. Just look after it with just nice hydrating products, some vitamin C, some hyaluronic acid, a good SPF, and it will be fine. So I'm going to put a little bit of SPF.
What about makeup? When can you sort of put makeup on?
Fine to cover now. We can use a sort of oxygen-based mineral
coverage, which
can work really nice. So of course, nobody likes downtime or a red face. You know, everyone wants to.
So you could actually have this in your lunch time, like if you came out.
If you have a little bit of a long lunch, then yeah, lucky.
You can have an hour and a half, maybe. But this, as you see, this hasn't taken very long. It was like 10 minutes to spin the blood. Obviously, there's consultation and everything. And then I don't think Nellie's skin looks aggravated at all, so she probably could pop back to the office and no one would notice.
It's funny because it does feel like something sort of quite drastic's happened. Do you know what I mean? It's like if you have a facial and just a mask and you feel it feels nice, but it doesn't feel like you've actually done anything.
Yeah, and that's
but
really
this does feel like something's sort of going on. Do you know what I mean?
That's really interesting that you say that, because most people want more than a facial now, but maybe they don't need injectables, so they don't need the Botox and they don't need the fillers, but they want something in between where they're going to get a little bit more for the money, rather than sometimes a good facial is great and I advocate them every month. But if you're only doing that and you're starting to age, it's probably not enough.
So many people won't accept standard fluffy facial anymore. They just want that little bit more. Yeah. So this is that next step without, needles as such. So is this good for acne and scarring? And
yeah, fantastic for acne and scarring. Again, using your own body to just really...
For healing,
exactly. Yeah.
This is.
So she's got a few little breakouts there, so we did go over them. So she's got some damaged skin, some aging skin, and a little bit oily. So what this will do is help to repair some of them spots and breakouts, and then repair some of the inflammation and the scarring that it's caused. So really nice as an all-over treatment.
So we're trying to do a screen grab and show Nellie's skin, and then we'll come back to her and we'll show you before and after. But if you are just catching the end of this, this was a vampire facial. We saw hardly any blood, if any at all. Nellie's very relaxed, as you can see, and this is meant to be an amazing anti-aging treatment. And Nellie can report back. So I think we're kind of done now. So I hope you enjoyed that. It's been a bit quiet, but we think we might all be on your lunch, and we're going to go up on our lunch now. So thank you to Natalie Kelly for having
us. Thank you.
And Nellie for being brave. And thanks for watching.
You did great.